Forge, Chapter 47. It being warm outside, there was no fire in the hearth or of our hut. Thin fingers of sunlight poked through the spaces between the logs, where the mud chinking had fallen out. It smelled heavily of a lad's unfamiliar with soap. "Sit and listen," Eben pushed my shoulders, forcing me to sit into one of the bunks and close the door. He quickly explained what happened after I'd left back in February. Burns had announced that I'd been arrested and returned to my rightful owner, and Benny had written up a petition to Captain Russell, asking the army to free me on account of my service. Every man in the company signed it, except Burns, of course. The captain threw it in the fire and said that the matter was not to be discussed again. That didn't sit well with any of us. We knew that you'd try to run one of these days. We talked about it and decided that we'd help if we could. Here. He pulled out a haversack from under the bed, or under the bunk. This is yours. I untied the cords. Inside was the compass box, along with my knife, my sorry-looking carving, and all my other belongings in the world. The lump in my throat would not allow me to speak. Benny should be here, too. Or should be here soon, Eben said. You need to strip off all those fancy breeches and lose the coat, I'm sorry to say. I swallowed the lump. What do you mean? It was the only thing that we could think of in such a short amount of time. Benny is going to dress in your clothes and pull your hat down low. You're about the same size. I talked extra loud on purpose when we walked up here. That was Faulkner's idea, so I'd be noticed. Me and Benny will walk back down the outer ridge road down to Wayne's regiment. The trees were heavier there. When we're out of sight, he'll change back into his own clothes, and he'll take you to a place to hide. Greenlaw and Aaron are working on that. I finally figured his aim. This is all to get me out of here? Of course, you chucklehead. Greenlaw will walk you over to the Sullivan's Bridge after dark. He'll say the two of you are going after a deserter. Once far enough away from the camp, he'll turn back and you're free to keep going to Aunt Patience's house outside of Leo Minister if you'd like. What say you? His homely face just looked as it had when we stood in the ravine and heard the approaching sounds of the Battle of Saratoga, eager and scared at the same time. You would do this for me? I asked. Surely, he answered. Yes, you would for me. The lump reappeared in my throat and required several sharp coughs to move it. I can't let you. Anyone who helps me will easily earn 50 lashes, maybe more. He peeled some of the bark off the bunk pole. Maybe it's not the soundest plan, but we hadn't had much time. We could devise a better one if you wish. I shook my head. Even if you made the best plans, I couldn't go. Bellingham has a maid, a friend of mine. I have not had not yet convinced her to run away. I can't leave her behind, and if I run, she'll be mistreated. A girl? He punched my shoulder hard enough to knock me over. 10,000 fellows in this camp, and you're the one who meets a girl? It's not like that. I shoved him back. Is she pretty? Uncle Caleb says to stay away from the pretty ones. Smart girls are better, he says. She's pretty and smart. Sharp tongue, too, and stubborn. Sounds like a good match. Why won't she run away? I stood up and walked to the hearth. She tried to escape several times before. Anger flashed over me. She was sorely abused with each capture. She desires freedom as much as me or you, but she won't run unless the plan is guaranteed and secure. Shh, Eben lifted his hand to quiet me. Heavy footsteps approached the hut when the door was thrown open by Henry Barry. It won't work, not today. The gentleman on the horse is already looking for him. Sergeant says to hurry back. He dashed off, leaving the door open and the light of day pouring in. I walked towards the door, but Eben stood and grabbed my arm before I could step outside. Wait, what should we do? How can we help you get out of there? There's no point in trying to liberate us from Moore Hall. The place is crawling with soldiers. I hesitated. There was one avenue of escape, but it carried risk. Our best chance will be when the troops march out of camp. Against the British? Aye. We could try to blend in with you somehow and walk with the army out of camp. I stepped over the threshold and saw Bellingham trotting up the road. I had only a few moments left. But you don't have to do this, Ebenezer. I don't want any of this to come to harm on my account. You're still a soldier, Curzon. You signed up till the end of the war, remember? Eben looked me square in the eye. What's the point of being a soldier if you can't count on your mates?